Hello friends, so in this video, we will study how to draw a pictograph. The class teacher, Mrs. Matthew, has 40 students in her class. The teacher is curious what students would like to become when they grow up. So, she conducts a quick survey to collect the data. Students started thinking and after a lot of thinking, they shared their answers. Some students wants to be doctor, some wants to be footballer, some wants to be filmmaker, some wants to be engineers. And a lot of information start coming from all the corners of the class. So, teacher was not able to keep a track of it. How would the teacher show this much information in a better way? Mrs. Matthew came up with the idea of pictograph. In pictograph, we will use pictures to represent different students what they want to become. Now, Mrs. Matthew took a help of student named Reema. She asked her to make a table with two columns. In one column to mention the types of profession and in the next column to mention the number of students. Let's see what Reema did. The first profession is a doctor. So Reema pasted one picture that shows that that student wants to be a doctor. Then she drew second picture which shows that second student wants to be a doctor. Likewise, she pasted 12 pictures which shows that 12 students wants to be doctor. Now, the second profession was engineering. Now, the 10 students wants to be engineer. So Reema start pasting the pictures. But after pasting 5 pictures, she went to the teacher. She asked teacher that this is so much data and it's taking a lot of time. So, Mrs. Matthew intervenes here and gave a solution to her. The teacher told her that you can represent the data by using one star picture to represent two students. She asked her to add a note in the end, which she termed as key. Now, in this way, there were 40 students in the class and Reema needs to show only 20 pictures. So, let's see what Reema finally did. Isn't this table so easy to understand? There are two stars in front of the footballer. It means 4 students want to be footballer. Similarly, 6 students wants to be musician. 8 students wants to be teacher. And so on. Now we have understood how to represent data using pictograph. So let's take one more example. Suppose we want to represent the numbers of hours studied by 5 students. Let's take our key is a picture of clock represent 2 hours and a picture of half clock represents 1 hour. Now first student spent 12 hours, so there are 6 clock pictures. Similarly, second student spent 8 hours, so there are 4 clock pictures. Now third student studies 11 hours, so it means we need 5 full clock pictures and 1 half clock picture, and so on. So here the key of pictograph is very important and we generally misinterpret the key. So we need to carefully read the key. So when you represent the data in this way, we call it pictograph. So it is a pictorial representation of data using symbols and pictures. Whereas the key of the pictograph is the numerical value that one symbol or picture represents. So I hope you understood the concept. Keep learning.